Have you ever wanted to learn how to create a multiplayer game in Unreal Engine 5, but were left wondering how everything worked? I get it. I used to feel lost too, especially when tutorials didn't explain why things worked. But today, not only are we going to dive into the multiplayer setup, but I'm going to break down the multiplayer blueprints you'll actually use. I promise you'll walk away with a full understanding of the essential. By the way, I'm Sketch and I've been debbing for over a decade, powered by a solid computer science foundation and a lot of caffeine. Trust me, I spent hours tweaking multiplayer setups and hitting dead ends, so today, I'll do my best to make this journey easier for you. Here's something you'll want to lock into your brain when working on multiplayer in UE5. Think of it as if you're creating two games, one for the client and one for the server. They need to be nearly identical, otherwise the client and the server can end up showcasing different things. And trust me, that leads to some of the most annoying bugs you'll ever deal with. So rule number one, always test both client and the server to make sure they match up. Now let's go into blueprints that make multiplayer magic happen, starting with the game mode, the backbone of your game rules. This is where you decide who can join, what the winning conditions are, and what weapon can be used. The game mode class was split into game mode base and game mode, giving you flexibility based on how many features your game needs. Game mode base is the lighter option if you don't need the full set. And here's a tip, game mode is only available on the server, so if you try to access it from the client, you'll get a null. If you're making something like a deathmatch game, use the post login function to add players to an array so you can keep track of them and respawn them later. It's a super useful feature for any player heavy game. Next up is the game state. Like game mode, it's split into game state base and game state, with the base version offering fewer features. Game state is crucial, it is the primary blueprint for tracking and sharing and a list of all connected players. Here's why game state is powerful. It's replicated across all clients so each player gets the same data, which is a game changer for consistency. Need to track team kills in deathmatch? Game mode keeps track of the kill limit, but game state tracks current team kills. Don't forget to use the player array in game state. It is the easiest way to get a list of all players. Now the player state is like the game state, but focused on each player individually. It's replicated across the server and client, which is huge for things like tracking players' names, kills, deaths, team ID, and even ping. If you're using a platform like Steam, this can also auto-fill your Steam or Epic usernames, so you don't have to worry about coding that in. And here's my tip, if you need an easy way to access all player states, use the player, array, and game state. Now let's talk about the pawn or character blueprint. In Unreal, the player can only possess one pawn at a time, but switching between characters is easy with unpossessing and repossessing function. When it comes to multiplayer, the movement of the characters is also replicated across clients, but if you have custom movement, you'll need to handle replication yourself. Now the player controller might be one of the most complex blueprints, but here's a solid rule of thumb. For one-time actions like jumping or firing, add them to the character blueprint. For persistent inputs like menus, keep those in the player controller. It's only available on the client side and the server, which helps keep everything clean and secure. Here's how to get player controller work in different setups. On the listen server, it'll return the server's player controller. On a client, it returns only the client's player controller. On a dedicated server, it'll return the first client player controller. This might seem a bit tricky, but once you nail it, you'll avoid tons of headaches. Let's finish up the HUD and widgets. The HUD class is client only and can be accessed through the player controller. It will automatically spawn, which is pretty convenient. As for widgets, remember, they don't replicate, so keep them local. They're ideal for visual elements and menus, but avoid putting any gameplay code in them. Now that you've got the basics of multiplayer blueprints, go ahead and build out your game mode. Test it on both client and server and start bringing your multiplayer vision to life. If you found this video helpful, make sure you subscribe and check out the video to the right for more dives on Unreal Engine multiplayer tips. See you there!